built a new a new building where there used to be a slum area, you have to integrate the slums into the new building. This is a new thing. In China, they move them outside the cities, and they probably would do the same here. And that way, that becomes ghettos. But if you integrated them in the same buildings as the people that move into the city, there'll be a bigger mixture of low and high in the buildings, which is, I think, is very important. And you get these very interesting areas with a lot of entrepreneurship and a lot of dealing all the time around, and which I really think is very nice. I have an example here that I can show of an earlier project that we are working on in India. So we have a site with a lot of slum in. This is a typical picture of Mumbai, where you have high and low, literally spread out, mixed in the city. So this is one of the best areas in Mumbai. This is the Worli area. But see how much slum there is. So but this is not a bad thing. This is how it is in Mumbai. It's not separated. It is mixed. So we have to mix these two inside one building. So the client wants a high rise, and on the lower floors we need to integrate the slum dwellers, and what we want to do is create some of the same qualities as they have in the slum, and that is an area where they can meet and interact, and where they can have this dealing that they really like to have too. But of course, at the same time, the people that moves into this very expensive high rise here, they want to have another way to come into the building. So we have to separate the two entrances to the building, but we try to mix them into one building. So what we do is take the brief for the high rise. It's called luxury high rise, and then we have the rehousing down here and put them literally together. In India, we have to have natural ventilation for every room, all the toilets, everything, because they don't believe if you have a ventilation that it will work after some years, and they don't maintain it. So, and you cannot have centralized ventilation because then people don't pay for it. So we have to do a natural ventilation for every part of the building. That's why we divide the building up in smaller parts, so we get a big surface, and we twist the buildings and we get a view out to the surroundings. And then we make a different entrances to the building, so the different parts of people can come in where they should come in. But the rehousing is down here, and there's actually a little school and everything integrated in the lower or the rehousing for the slum dwellers. So this is how it's gonna come out. And be a new part of this area here. So slowly, of course, the city is changing, with the slums are moving away, but the slum dwellers will still be living in the area. And actually, this is a machine that's functioning together, because the drivers and the maids and whatever is living down here, and they're working up there. So it is going to be a machine that's working together. In the future, this will probably change too, and I hope so too.